secretary.
President, how are you?
Well, please.
Excuse me for a moment.
Very aware our administration is and willing to take advantage of opportunities. Ed Meese was supposed to be with us this morning, but he's not feeling well. So long morning. Well, let me just say I appreciate the opportunity to meet with you here today. And 1983 may prove to be a landmark in the debate to receive your views on important health issues. This will be a watershed year for two reasons. The American people, I think we're all aware, are increasingly concerned about rising health care costs, particularly since cost increases in other areas have moderated so substantially. And our present budgetary situation naturally focuses attention on rapidly rising costs for health care programs. The challenge we face is to meet these problems without diminishing the quality of care available to the American people and without doing damage to our nation's private health care delivery system, which other countries have tried it, and if you have to get sick, this is the best country in which to get sick. As you know, last week I sent a message on health care policy to Congress, and in that message outlined a serious proposals that argue, pardon the phrase, tough medicine. I know from reading about the AMA's official reaction to those proposals that there are a number of concerns you have about various aspects. We propose that hospitals be reimbursed with set charges for various illnesses rather than being paid on a cost-plus basis. Naturally, you're concerned about what that might imply for government interference on individual courses of treatment. We've also proposed the so-called catastrophic coverage be provided to people with heavy hospital bills. And yet concerns have been raised about whether costs of such a program would get out of hand. We've also proposed increased cost consciousness on the part of the patient, a position which I understand that you've favored in the past. And finally, we propose that individuals be given the choice to either stay on their present government insurance coverage under Medicare or else receive a voucher with which they can purchase comparable private coverage. Concerns have naturally been raised as to whether such a system might favor one sort of healthcare practitioner over another. But I want to assure you that any proposal from the federal government, and even from our administration, can always be improved by consulting with outside experts. And I've long known that the American Medical Association is the leading voice, America's healthcare experts, or private physicians. So I hope you'll share your thoughts with us today on how we can work with the Congress to ensure that whatever they enact is proper and fair. And I also want to encourage you and the staff to work with Secretary Heckler and Undersecretary Spahn over at HHS to make your views known and give us the benefit of your advice. And so saying, the meeting is open for those very purposes. I cannot stay, I know, entirely, and I believe in these good hands here that are with me. They scheduled me that way all the
time. Mr. President, before you get away, let me just say on behalf of Ms. Rao and myself, we want to thank you, Leon. You did the American Medical Association inviting us to dinner in San Francisco the other night. We're most grateful, and the whole association, I think, appreciated the fact that you honored us that way. We have several concerns, and may I address the first one, that is the issue of the change in organization of the department to elevate the undersecretary to.
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
President,
hi.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Good.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes.
President.
Harper.
How are you?
Hello. Listen, I think they want to press availability and photo availability, and we were all going to stand over here so they could come in and
how many waves?
One way. We know that, right?
I'll save any remarks I have for when they all get in here. The green ashtray, as you can see, is the harp and pterosaur. It was presented to me by a first cousin of the new secretary of the Human Services, just here, swearing in.
can't receive any.
Because from Ireland, the name of Buckley came.
Mr. President, one of my secretaries asked for a signature on this picture, which you all recognize. She's from the John K. McKee family. Her father is there. She came up with this, and she's going to maybe inscribe it with John K. McKee family. It goes back a bit.
Yes, that's Andy Sheridan.
Yes. Who is this man?
What year would it be? This has to be. Yes, that's all.
Oh my God. Thought that was kind of fun.
I hope that very shortly now we gather around here for a signing. Sign the Social Security legislation. It's a great example of bipartisanship and statesmanship.
Well, we want to thank you, Mr. President, for your part in calling the commission. I really never thought I was going to be able to work out the way it did, but Democrats and Republicans and the ways in these communities to put together. Dan and Bob did a beautiful job, and Jake, of course, was the subcommittee chairman. So we're all grateful that it's behind us on our side of the House, and I trust and hope it'll be in your desk.
Mr. President, I'd just like to give a little credit to the membership of the House of Representatives, because it was the long term that was the big problem.
And the game crashing through.
And the commission just gave us options, but we made the decisions. The long term settled in the House of Representatives, and through the way the new committee where it should have been.
But the beauty of the thing is that the senior citizen, the golden age, has nothing to worry about, at least for the next 30 odd years.
And we're getting to that age.
Well, the victim yet to Social Security system. I mean, the individual putting the advance this bill on a bipartisan basis, and it's important we keep it that way.
Yes.
Mr. President, what's to prevent each side from continuing to escalate in El Salvador?
I think I'm going to be talking over you. Maybe tomorrow, I don't know, but I'll take any questions you want to go on.
Thank you.
Well, we're delighted, and I'm sure there are other things we can work together. Always the best ones.
We're looking forward to the signing.
Yes, sir, thank you. The Roger Museum.
Sir, would you just hand this to the John McKee family? They're the group there. My secretary is the daughter of one.
Gee, that's an amazing picture, isn't it? That is really something.
I think it's kind of fun.
John McKee.
John McKee.
You must imagine that 40 years ago.
The guy's helped the world still. That's the amazing. You hear what I said, Mr. President? I said, all this help us looks too. That's the amazing.
This was given the president for the second.
I should have called before I left, but we were looking at the
grandmother.
Every now and then you get an echo from the past.
This is the schedule that when we were in this office, I gave to you. I am sure that you didn't keep it. But there's when we began, and that's when I said I'd be on the floor. And we missed it by a day only because the Rules Committee didn't meet.
That's why.
Mr. President, we think that's leadership.
That's the way it's a lot of work. That's
amazing. It really is.
So he said when he'd have to get it done, and he got it done then. And he got it done in good shape.
They're coming in here.
I remember last time when I was here, that was one of the subjects of discussion.
Yes.
Yes. And really could not.
Well, I'm anxious to hear your views on our friends over there and what things now look like and with regard to deployment and INF and so forth.
I think on the INF, we still are moving in the right direction. The patterns are remaining very firm. We're still making preparations at the site in Greenham Common in the United Kingdom. And with Chancellor Cole re-elected, I think the chances are extremely good for Pershing II to go on. So I'm optimistic on this. There'll be a lot of demonstrations as the time approaches. Remaining firm as we have within the alliance has had its impact.
Well, Colombo thought when he was here, and he would have thought that with the better on the way, that maybe we should, without giving up, that is not.
Excuse me, we
do still have the press here, so
we
just hold that. Long hours.
This is John Weber, who received his father's money, and this is Fred Weber.
Mr. President?
Yeah, Mr. Weber.
Enjoyed your speech today, Dan. It was excellent.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
And this is the chairman of the National Indian Foundation, Mr. Burns and Kennedy. And Dr. Ogden.
How are you?
And Charlie Engler of the local DC chapter.
Well, I know that. John, I know you're a representative of the 4,000 people a year who get kidney transplants. And your father, who gave you life to begin with, certainly showed love and devotion that I'm sure you're aware of and appreciate. And I understand that this is you're having a blitz program now for donors to sign up and so forth.
We sure are. We've been very successful with it. Just trying to get the word out to the people so the people understand the importance of the need for transplantation.
Yeah. You know, he now can be his father in tennis, Mr. President, and he's an A student, honor roll. Isn't that wonderful?
Hey. Well, it sure
is.
You know, that's quite a moment for a father when I remember in my case, one of my sports was swimming, and I remember the day finally in the pool when Junior took over. Of course, I always laid it down to the fact that we did a lap up and down, and I was still turning the old-fashioned way. I didn't know about the flip turn. So I tried to cling to the fact that that's how he beat me.
Well, it hurts a little bit, but he's regularly now beating me.
Right.
I'd like to present you, Mr. President, with a membership in the National Kidney Foundation.
Well, thank you very much. Appreciate that.
And welcome to the club.
Right. Mr. President, he pointed out that you'll be back next year and the next year and all those other years for your second term.
Right here in the White House.
I'm quoting him on that.
I won't respond. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you. There's a picture of Mr. Weber, the son of the
Oh.
Mr. Here? Here.
Well, mine will.
Surely.
Great. Thank you, sir.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Well, good to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
We appreciate your support.
Mr. President, thank you very much for
Thank you.